So good morning dear cadets. So we are in the forest, our lifeline. Okay. So yesterday we talked about the fertile bed of forest. So you know that the fertility of the forest soil is because of the humus. And from where humus is coming? Humus is coming because the dead body of plants and animals are decomposed by the decomposer. And all the nutrients which are present in their body released to the soil. So the fertility of the soil is very much as far as forest is concerned. And now this is serving useful purpose for the growth of new plants. Okay. So just let us have some idea about the decomposer, because they are very important as far as the forest is concerned, for recycling of the nutrients. So what are the decomposer? The decomposers are the microorganisms. What are they? Decomposers are the microorganism which convert the dead plants and animal to humus, are known as decomposer. So what are the decomposer? They are nothing but a microorganism. What are they? Microorganism which convert the dead plants and animal body into humus. And humus is only the fertile part of the soil. Now try to understand, what are the examples? Examples of decomposers are fungus, fungi you might have heard, fungus, mushroom, okay? Mushroom is one type of fungus. Bacteria, there are so many bacteria. Insects, these are the decomposers. And see, whenever any, you might have seen the small animals which die, then what is there? You might have seen so many small insects, virus, especially bacteria, not virus, bacteria are surrounding that one and they are decomposing their body. Okay, so they are the decomposer. Why they are called so? Because they decompose the body of plants and animals. Okay, now what is the role of decomposer? Now decomposer are playing very important role. How? Just see, decomposer decompose the dead body of plants and animal and recycle the nutrients into the soil. Okay, again same nutrients is absorbed by the roots of the plant. Okay, again it is absorbed by the roots of plant. So now nutrient is recycled or not? Not only this, the dead body of animals are eaten by the vulture, crows, jackals as well, hence their nutrients are also recycled. So what is the conclusion of this one? Nothing goes waste in the forest. What we can say? Nothing goes, we can write here, nothing goes waste in the forest. Okay, nothing goes waste in the forest. That is the meaning of the things which are present in the forest, nothing goes waste. Everything is recycled, everything is useful. And why nothing goes waste in the forest? Because of decomposer. Okay, nothing goes waste in the forest. Now suppose I am asking one question. Explain this sentence. Nothing goes waste in the forest. Explain. How you will explain? Just same thing you will write here. The decomposers which are found in the forest, they decompose the dead body of plants and animal and release the nutrients to the soil. Same nutrients is absorbed by the roots. And that nutrients is useful for the growth of plants. Not only this one, if dead animals are there, so animals are eaten by the these animals, vulture, crows, jackals. So dead animals nutrients are now reaching to the body of these birds or animal. So their nutrients is also recycled or not? So nothing goes waste in the forest, we can say. There is one more question here. How forest is responsible for maintaining the balance of oxygen and carbon dioxide? Okay, that is the most important question. So the role of forest in maintaining the balance between carbon dioxide and oxygen. So dear cadets, just see here, role of forest in maintaining the balance between carbon dioxide and oxygen. So just see, both gases are very important for us. Just see, plants, what they are doing? Plants are doing photosynthesis process with the help of their green leaves. What they are doing? Just see, here I wrote, they are absorbing water with the help of root, and carbon dioxide through stomata, okay? And they are converting this water and carbon dioxide gas into carbohydrate, that is the food, and oxygen gas they are releasing, okay? Now this is happening in chlorophyll of the leaves and in presence of sunlight. You know, in the chapter number first I told. Now this oxygen gas is released here. Who is releasing this oxygen gas? Plants are releasing the oxygen gas with the help of photosynthesis process. So O2 gas is released by plants, okay? So here I wrote released from O2, I wrote the oxygen also, I wrote released from photosynthesis process. And now this oxygen is taken by the animals by the process called respiration, okay? So animal, what is there? We are doing like that, or not? We breathe in, we breathe out. What is there? So what we breathe in? We breathe in oxygen, and we breathe out carbon dioxide gas. So we breathe in oxygen gas with the help of respiration process, with the help of respiration process. So oxygen gas, which is released by plant, now taken by the animal. Now animal, this animal, they gives out carbon dioxide gas. So that carbon dioxide gas again will be taken by the plants, will be absorbed by the plants, and again they will utilize it for the photosynthesis process. So just see, respiration, this oxygen which we have taken here, that is used to decompose or break down carbohydrate into carbon dioxide gas and water. So whatever is reactant here, whatever is reactant in photosynthesis process, that is the product in respiration process. Similarly, whatever is the product here in photosynthesis, that is the reactant in respiration process. So what we can say, respiration and photosynthesis process are responsible for maintaining the balance between carbon dioxide and oxygen gas. And now who is doing the photosynthesis? Plants. Who is doing the respiration? Animals, okay? So both balance should be there, means the number of plants and the number of animals, both should be in balance, then only oxygen and carbon dioxide balance will be there in this atmosphere. Now what is the role of forest in maintaining the balance between carbon dioxide and oxygen? Just try to understand. If plants are less, trees are not there, then who will absorb this carbon dioxide gas? No one is there to absorb this carbon dioxide gas. So in this surrounding, what would be there? Only carbon dioxide would be there. And you know, carbon dioxide is responsible for global warming. Now the temperature of this earth will increase very much. And then what would be there? Our survival would be difficult, okay? Similarly, suppose animals are less, only what is there? Oxygen is there, only plants are there. So what would be there? Now here in the surrounding, only oxygen, then you know what would be there? If the concentration of oxygen is more, then what is there? Oxygen is the supporter of combustion. So everything will be burned, even small spark would be there. So that fire will be broken out, and the controlling of fire will be difficult. So the role of forest is very much in maintaining the balance of carbon dioxide and oxygen. How? This is the role I have explained. Same way you can write, okay? So just see here, plants, they are releasing the oxygen gas. which is taken by the animal, which is taken by the animal in respiration process, okay? And in turn they release the carbon dioxide gas which is absorbed by the plants again by the photosynthesis process, okay? So in this way what would be there? Plants means forest only, because plants are found in the forest, okay? So meaning of this one is forest plants would be there, they must be there in the forest in sufficient number, then only oxygen gas will be released. There is no problem in the animal side. Why? Because just see, even they fall sick, doctors are there. Even if they are unable to work, their family members are there, they are feeding them, okay? So many people are there to take care of one particular animal. But what about plants? We are only taking care of plant. No one is there to take care of plant. So that is why plant should be taken care of, so that sufficient amount of oxygen should be released. Okay? So in this way, forest is playing very important role in maintaining the balance between oxygen and carbon dioxide gas. Now note down the question. What are the question? First question is, what are decomposer? What are decomposer? Okay, name them. Okay, now question number second, write the role of decomposer. Decomposer. Okay, this is question number two. Now question number third. Explain the role of forest in maintaining balance between carbon dioxide and oxygen. Okay, so explain the role of forest in maintaining the balance between carbon dioxide and oxygen. It's okay, no problem. So these are the three questions. If you want to explain that question also. Nothing goes waste in the forest. Okay, just do that one also. In this way, the duration of today's video is over. Thank you.